What is that picture there?
It's a self-portrait I did. I was 11 years old. I was into music, of course, but I had a few weeks of doubt. I was very attracted to the sea. If you look carefully on the chair, there's a sailor hat. But then I changed my mind.
Did you really have a choice?
I don't know, maybe not. Maybe not, but I was very close to the, yeah. In the house, everybody was making music, my father, my grandfather, and so on. Maybe for a moment I had a desire to escape from that musical prison, a very pleasant prison, actually. I had that doubt, but it was very short. Then I tend, with the years, of course, to sublimate the idea of the sea to other domains, not only physical, visual, practical, if you want, musically, too.
Il papà di Luciano Berio, Ernesto Berio, è stato per molti anni l'organista ufficiale della chiesa di San Giovanni Battista, chiesa che gli ha riconosciuto la sua attività. È singolare che anche il nonno di Luciano Berio sia stato l'organista ufficiale della chiesa di San Giovanni Battista. Lo vediamo qui rappresentato assieme alla sua signora. Abbiamo trovato la messa a tre voci Duomo di Ernesto Berio del 1935, ancora cori e voci sole, maggiolata, vediamo che dentro c'è una romanza. Qui vicino abbiamo dei quaderni di Luciano Berio che rappresentano il momento che Berio è stato a scuola, era l'era fascista. Qui è un quaderno con l'effigie dei militari, dell'esercito.
That tree was not there when I was here. Beautiful tree, magnolia tree. My father studied here too. My father took me here in, let's say, 1939, 38, something. He wanted to show me the conservatory where he studied. And then in 1945, immediately after the war, I came here myself. Of course, it was very important for me to go away from this little town, provincial town, musically speaking. And to come to Milano was very important for me. I remember very clearly the feeling that I had to rush, to gain all the time I lost with the war, with fascism. We were completely cut off, you see. And so it was very intense, very
hectic. I was hungry. Like somebody been starving for a long time. And you realize what you missed. And so I was not the only one, but my friend too, they just grasping, trying to know everything.
After the war, was there a feeling of a new beginning?
Not for me. Yeah, in the new beginning, of course, in the sense that it was such an immense relief, such a... Then try to build on the ruins of the past.
Each other.
1955. It was at the Italian television and radio in Milano where I was working at the second floor. At the fifth floor there was the laboratory of musical phonology, that was the name. And there I met people like Stockhausen, Boulez, and so forth. So it was really a sort of a foyer in which many things happened at that time. But all the Milano atmosphere was incredible in the 50s. I remember when Giorgio Strehler staged for the first time the Dry Goshen Opern with people like Gino Negri and other preparing the Kurt Weill music, and I saw Bertolt Brecht there, and it was a sort of central square, this building in which a lot of things happened.
No, ecco, no. Ritualizza di più la cosa, se no non fai, devi fare il gesto che fai su è sempre lo stesso, capisci? Poi una volta lo fai il stesso gesto senza il suono, però. È un gag. Fai in modo che la voce sia più o meno allo stesso livello del trombone, invece. Sì. Ci sia identità tra voce.
Posso prendere più tempo?
No.
Ah.
È la stessa nota, cerca di prendere la stessa nota anche.
Allora faccio da qui.
Troppo debole la voce. Fa un po' il why un pochino più solenne. Why? Sei un clown, non dimenticare.
Why? Così va bene?
Benissimo.
Why?
Più grave, fai vedere già che ci sei, fai più registro più grave. Why?
Con voce più bassa.
Okay. Voce...
Why?
Sente bene? Chiudere la bocca. Ecco. Benissimo.
Luciano Berio in this sense, maybe many of his generation, but Luciano Berio most of all, is and was a musician continuously excited by the great cultural problems of our time, trying always to put his music, his musical problems in connection with all the trends and currents of the contemporary world. And this seems to me a very important business. You have only to think that he obliged to work for him, I say for him and not with him, because when a writer writes something for Berio, then Berio put cut and paste everything. But Italo Calvino, poets like Sanguinetti, and so on. So one day or another, somebody should write the story of the all the connection between Luciano Berio and contemporary culture, and I think it is important to outline exactly his figure as a musician.
Bronze by gold, heard the hoof iron steely ringing, impertinent. Chips, picking chips on plucky thumbnail chips. Horrid and gold flushed more. Ask blue bloom is on the gold pinnacled hair. I jumped in rows on satin rose of Castile. Fring, I do Boris. Who's in the peep of gold?
Okay.
And a call. Decoy. Decoy. But look! Oh, rose next to the answer. Steel, the moon is blinking. Dingle, dingle, daughter tingling. 29 clock, that's. Wow. Sonar. I could. Rebound of God. Not leaving. Snack, that lost. Bye, snack. Oh, sweetheart, goodbye.
Ils font le trou pour avec un fil de fer, tu peux pas faire le trou comme ça. Et il y en a qui sont tordus comme ça. Hein.
Comment ils font ça?
Alors, ils mettent, c'est un bois qui est très dur autour et le centre est très mou. Comme alors, ils mettent du miel et c'est des fourmis qui, pendant des années, mangent la chose pour arriver au bout. Tu savais pas?
Oui.
Il y a eu un festival d'orchestre remarquable, mais après j'ai rempli la ville de musique. Je voulais faire une recherche sur les notes des cloches de toutes les églises. La majorité des cloches, ils ont en commun le si bémol. Uh-huh. Alors, j'avais fait inviter un millier de bandes qui jouent dans la bande,
oui.
des meilleurs romans partout,
oui.
qui jouaient partout. Et alors, 5 heures, on devait jouer tout le monde en si bémol, et chanter aussi, avec l'espoir que tout que se fait crouler toutes les églises. Mais
le temps
les gars,
est
vous savez, la pluie a...
T'as vu, le bon Dieu, il sait exactement ce qu'il faut faire.
The purely structuralistic way was implied the possibility of establishing a language, a new language, which is philosophically is completely wrong. You don't invent languages. You can only help to an evolution of language. And you don't invent language in a musical language, or you don't invent even the musical instruments. You cannot even destroy them. You can contribute to evolution. This, of course, was a consequence of Schoenberg poetics, in a way. It's a 12-tone vision in his mind. It was the establishment of a new language, which did not happen, of course. In fact, all the serial experience that was very important for everybody, from other reasons I will tell you in a moment, but became a kind of an escape from responsibility. Was a kind of a safe space without dangers, where you could you felt protected, and the musician didn't take any risk.
Meaningless. Oh, rolling. Oh, verdome. This is another place where you have to, in a way, show your imagination. You have to make an onomatopoeia, imitation of those phrases written in your part with the instruments. It's hushed. It's a yeah, exactly. Then in molar, a vibraphone of your own. Yeah. Carved. You have a carved. Why not? Cling, 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 the singer, cling, cling, go. Hey! Ya, ti, ta, ta, ra, ra, we dream.
Uomini e donne
studiano giorno e notte.
Si sente come un fischio di treno.
di treno. Un bel minè di treno, come un fischio, non va a cambiare texto. Presente il flauto l'altra volta.
Wonderful, but maybe not so comfortable war. You are doing something new. You are the first example of a vertical orchestra, of a vertical choir. And please, from your altitude, I'd like to thank you with all my heart.
Always been against the orchestra pit. The orchestra pit becomes a filter, they're dangerous, it doesn't work anymore. And Cronica del Luogo is a special case because there's a harmonic wall from which I derive many things. So that wall is always there in a way, in a form or another. In fact, while they're singing, doing this, there is always this, an element, segment, layer of that wall on which things are inscribed, if you want. I feel that there is a lot around us. And we simply have to be aware of what is there and to extract, to isolate these things, to bring into light, to develop them, but knowing that they have roots very deep. And I'm not a religious person, but these roots are something holy, in a way.
Le treno, le chemin de fer, c'est trop faible, il faut qu'il fasse fort. Surtout le deuxième. Prova il treno adesso. Lui funziona, ma lui no.
Siamo allo stesso livello, forse.
Même un peu plus fort.
Mettiamo su noi, possiamo tirare ancora.
No, ma la spazializzazione non funziona. Perché?
Sul primo?
Sul primo non funziona, il secondo sì. D'accordo, va, vedi.
Thank you. Luciano, c'était bien parce qu'il veut toujours, il a toujours voulu les choses très très complexes. Les choses. Il a cette imagination, parce que les techniciens, quelquefois, ils ne pensent pas à certaines choses. Ces personnes avaient pensé à 1000 oscillateurs il y a 25 ans. Et aussi dans cette pièce-là, il y a des choses très complexes. Il n'existe pas des boîtes qu'on peut acheter. J'ai une boîte qui... Il y a des idées fous. Quelquefois, on peut les faire, quelquefois, c'est difficile, mais quelquefois, on arrive. Et ça, c'est bien. Parce que quelquefois, je fais une réflexion. Si vous parlez avec des jeunes, toute la musique électronique, c'est toute la musique pop, la musique, c'est eux qui font la recherche musicale. À la fin, toute la technologie musicale qui utilise les grands concerts, les grands pop stars, il est né pas des pop stars, il est né des grands musiciens comme Luciano Berio, Pierre Boulez, John Cage, qui avaient des choses fous. Mais ces choses fous, après, ils sont tous dans ces boîtes-là dedans.
Bon, alors je vais chanter en direct. Bon, oui, je vais chanter en direct. Je vais chanter en direct. C'est mieux si je fais Star Trek.
Bon, alors je vais chanter en direct. Bon, oui, je vais chanter en direct.
Et David aussi va chanter en direct. Et David aussi va chanter en direct.
It's a sensor problem.
It's a sensor problem.
Yeah. One.
Proviamo. I don't know which is one.
Try one.
I don't know which is one.
We can try everyone.
No, it's four.
Two. Four.
Three. Four. Yeah, three.
Eight.
Perfect.
Facce di cani, di corni.
Di corni.
Di daini.
Di daini. Tabelle.
Tabelle. No, tabelle.
Tabelle.
Tromboni.
Tromboni I have.
Mitzrayim.
Mitzrayim, but the way I have to say it is Mitzrayim. Okay.
Which is Egypt, mm-hmm. Alessandria.
Alessandria.
Tzarfat.
Tzarfat.
Roma.
Roma.
Do you still have any doubt about the text? Everything is clear?
Text-wise, it's clear. It's only my interpretation that you have to tell me about. Yeah.
Very good. You should stretch here and there, especially on the words.
Okay.
To bite the words,
mm-hmm.
So that it's not a text set to music, but uh-huh. There are explosions in the voice. The performs the explosion in the text. So the text sometimes is filtered by what you do. Sometimes comes out. If it must be a surprise every time.
Okay.
So that. Either with this or with the voice, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
It's too polite.
Too polite. Oh, okay. Huh? I'm gonna make it more.
Città ardente, ardente.
Ci città, ardente, 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 ardente,
gern nochmal das probieren. Kannst du deinen Platz nehmen, bitte schön? Tiefer in tiefer bin.
Can you both look to him and then say, okay, let's go? Yeah? And then you follow him. Every time you turn around, you do a step back and he's doing a step front. So you're a little separated. And then you walk.
When he respects what is written in the score, okay. Everything goes well. Took me 2 months to tell him to have the step to go up.
Does the director follow your written instructions?
Or what I told him to do in this scene. But the big problem is the last scene.
Piazza.
A piazza. You see there.
What don't you like there?
It doesn't mean anything. Just an empty head. Empty heart, empty head, empty everything. I'm against any form of minimalism. In visual arts, minimalism is reduced to a kind of a using forms detached from meaning. It's a form of fascism. If you, from the moment you're not aware of the meanings, of the connection, the network of a relation, not only with the techniques, but also with history, it's intellectually criminal. Really, I'm against totally this, and in the past I fought against fascism, and now when I can, I try to fight against this attitude. And of course in Salzburg becomes a very delicate issue.
Plus de violon.
Guardi le finestre, scende.
Sì, ma manca la ragione della tenda. Sì. Questo
è il punto. Il faut se voir un peu avec la partition.
Oui, tout à fait.
We still, after the last note, we still here. We still hear some winds.
Tu es trop tard.
Le délai était trop tard, était coupé trop tard.
Fermé le tuyau trop tard, c'est
bon. Ah oui,
mais this is the.
Tout le délai vient finir les primes.
OK.
L'amplification du violon,
c'était vraiment, vraiment moins intéressant. Et alors après, elle s'est complètement perdue parce qu'elle, justement, elle entendait beaucoup plus que d'habitude et elle s'est perdue là. Ça, on va le refaire de toute façon. Ça, il faut le refaire. Il y a un problème.
La balance avec la clarinette, c'est pas juste en tout cas. C'est pour ça qu'elle en amplifie un peu plus. Ou ça suffirait qu'il bouge un peu plus, qu'on le voit pendant qu'il joue. Quand on voit quelqu'un qu'on joue, on écoute mieux. Alors, il est caché derrière tout le monde.
Oui, mais bon, d'accord. Nous, on a voulu respecter le diminuendo poco a poco.
Non, mais il joue des choses pianissimo,
bien sûr,
de Klezmer.
Et nous jouons le plus pianissimo possible.
Non, il faut l'amplifier, en tout cas. Alors, c'est sa position qui est fausse par rapport à ce qu'il joue. Il faudrait le voir un peu plus avant.
Enfin, moi, j'ai trouvé ça moins bien qu'hier. Voilà. Maintenant, c'est ta partition, tu fais ce que tu veux. Enfin, moi, personnellement, je trouve que ça, on pourrait s'en passer. Mais bon, c'est comme ça que tu fais.
Once you finish writing a score, do you let it go? Does it stop being yours?
No, it belongs even more. Why? No, no. It's like having a, I don't know, somebody you love. You've been spending months in very intense work, and so you want. The first instinct is to protect it, as you protect, I don't know, one of your children. And then I think a work always stays there, because I don't believe that in any form of creativity, be in science, in music, in literature, in painting, they are separate entity, objects. The certain works take shape because something else happened before. There's a continuity. It's like a journey. And these works simply are signaling the moment of this journey. But the journey continues.
So this is like then staccato then? Or
open staccato, yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Maybe I'll change it, you know, we'll discuss it.
Yeah, okay.
The best way to notate.
Yeah, okay, great.
Okay, these are the first 4 or 5 minutes.
Great.
Can you show us some corners that you especially like here?
Let me think. That. Down there.
Shall we go there?
Yeah, certainly.
This is the only sculpture I bought in all my life. There was a nice man from Germany who was doing this metal sculpture that they look like trees in a way, and so I thought it was a good connection between nature and art. Then the nice thing of the culture is because with the wind moves, you see. And then I like the view also of the valley down. Oh, these are new trees that I bought from Talia's birthday. Did she tell you? That one, many. 20. And this is a very rare tree, this more from Ethiopia. The village, just after the war, they had 42 shoemakers. They were producing shoes for a good part of Tuscany. Quanti calzolai c'erano? 42 era, dicono. Anche prima o dopo la guerra?
Ma anche dopo la guerra ce n'era sempre parecchi.
That is the new vineyard. That is the old one. There. We collect it here and then it goes down. Yeah. Beautiful flowers. I forgot about them. Yeah. I love to be here because the quiet, the people in the village are very, very, very nice, very intelligent, very gentle, very sensitive. And then I like this contact with nature, with simple things. I'm also it's part of my music, if you want. The appreciation of the smallest detail in connection with the larger one.
It seems to me that you appreciate craftsmanship very much.
You appreciate
not that. Meisters.
Yeah, you too, everybody, I think. It's an essential part of my life, I would say. It's part of a truth. I like truth.
Isn't it something that is disappearing from the world?
No, it's disturbed, certainly, because of diversities of influence, mixing together a different culture. So sometimes it's difficult to recognize what for you is the truth. But also there's an inner truth that is more important. The one you find in the libraries, for instance. By the way, I have a wine library here. Deep down, things remain solid. And the music has to cope with this, too. Of course, there is a music that's more permanent, stronger. I think what we do, in a way. And then there's a music that goes quickly. Why not? The same applies to literature, to design, to building houses, and so on. But the permanent things are there, like growing wine and plants and the natural process.
If you had to choose one of your discs here at home, which one would you choose?
A disc, a recording?
Yes. Of what you have here in the house?
Well, so many, I don't know. Depends on the time of the day, of the year, or whether. In this moment, let me think. I would like to hear again a very small piano piece I wrote for Boulez's birthday in London, which is a starting point, can I say, the nucleus, the structural, base structural part of a project of a very large piano work, my first sonata for piano. I believe in subtractive behavior. I mean, to be aware of a totality from which you extract meaningful things, closer to the a sculpture work. In Italian, you have an expression: a forza di levare, by taking out, then. This is a phrase of Michelangelo, by the way. He was going to Carrara marble place. He was looking with his big, strong face, and he was pointing, I want that block, because he saw already more or less what could extract from that. And musically, I think it's the same. I'm not attracted to the idea of what we call an additive procedure, which has been very present in all Eastern music, in a way. You start from the cell, you add, you develop, you add something else, and then you grow up, you make a big construction. I believe that the possibility of going back and forth, Goethe developed this, that from the flower, from the leaves to the roots, there is a constant transition, transformation, but it's very unified in the same time. And I believe that is very important. I like to have an idea of the tree, to start from the tree, from the shape of the tree, or whatever, and to go back to the roots gradually. And when you have clarified the roots, you can go back to the tree. And this constant passage, journey from small, hidden, to large and invisible, it's very important. And the passage from the small to the large, from the roots of the tree, doesn't have to be continuous. It can be full of accidents, full of small discoveries.
Walk, walk, walk. bello, mi sento allegre. Consegno. Bene, bene. Delizio.
Is there a difference between the way you conducted Sinfonia 20 years ago and today?
Yes, I know it better as a conductor. And it's very difficult to conduct, not simple. But I'm more relaxed. And, no, it was 32 years ago, my God.
Come va? Bene, è arrivato tra di noi, grazie, che mi fa un gran piacere.
Grazie.
Le volevo dire anche una cosa, che probabilmente faremo la messa di Ernesto.
Ma no?
Sì, al Festival di Lecce. Allora. Io l'ho messa in programma appunto perché ho detto non è una cosa difficile
no,
da fare.
Coro maschile.
Appunto, esatto.
Coro maschile, ecco. D'accordo.
La prendo in parola. Ogni tanto forse la disturberò più,
certo,
la cadena.
Certo.
Mi auguro che rimanga, no?
Adesso vediamo.
Auguri finiti.
Grazie. My grandfather was a great virtuoso of the organ, and he was playing, but obviously with the, against the, in a way or another, against the church. During the offertorium, you know, when the organist is alone, can play freely whatever he wants. He was playing Rossini, Rossini overture. My father also was a more cultivated musician, was a pianist and organist too. And sometimes I went there myself when they couldn't go, they didn't want to go. I play organ myself a few times, yes.
Thank you.
search is also means to change your relation with history. We are not, it's not true that we are slaves of the product of history. We invent history too. We reinvent the past history, which is very important to have a dialogue with the past. But not the past is not a prison. It's a space to explore constantly, to have a dialogue with the past. And then in music especially, you see that we can invent a new vision of the past. Was there, was hidden. And then today music can bring a different idea of the past.